We'll talk about that a little more later. Before I go on, I want to mention one very important principle in cryptography, which is known as Kerchoffs principle. And it goes back to a book that Kerchoffs wrote back in 1883. And the way Kerchoffs stated it was this. This was in a book he wrote in 1883 about military cryptography. Faut qu'il n'exige pas le secret et qu'il puisse sans inconvénient tomber entre les mains d'ennemis. And I apologize for my French, but this loosely translates as the cipher must not depend on secrecy of the mechanism. It must not matter if it falls into the hands of the enemy. So the reason for that, and it's important what he's focusing on, is the mechanism here. So if you think about these two functions we need encryption and decryption. Coming up with new functions or new mechanisms, in Kerchoff's day, these were mostly mechanical devices that you needed as part of the encryption process. Well, that's a lot of work. You don't want to have to keep inventing new encryption and decryption functions and deciding they're secure and distributing them. What you want is some way that even if your encryption and decryption functions are known, your cipher can still be secure. And the way to achieve that is to use a key. So instead of just having the message as input to the encryption function, the other input to the encryption function is a key. And if it's a symmetric crypto system, that same key is the key that is needed in the decryption function as well. If the security relies only on keeping the key secret, well, then we can make our encryption and decryption functions public. We can analyze them. We can put a lot of work into developing good encryption and decryption functions. And then the security depends only on keeping the key secret. If we think our key has been exposed, well, then we just need to come up with a new key, but we can keep using the same functions. If the function turns out to have a weakness in it, well, that's a much more serious problem. Then we need to develop a new encryption function and argue that that new function is secure. So this quiz is to check that you understand Kerchoff's principle and understand the terms that we've defined. So the question is, which parts of a crypto system must be kept secret? The choices are Alice, the algorithm used for encryption, the algorithm used for decryption, the keys, and the ciphertext. Check all the parts that must be kept secret.